Modern optical telescopes use mirrors and very few lenses. Unlike bathroom mirrors, where the shiny layer is sealed into the back of the glass, telescopes use so-called first surface mirrors with a reflective layer on top. This makes them difficult to clean. When they get dirty or they lose reflectivity over time, they need to be re-aluminised. Professional telescopes in constant use need their mirrors to be re-aluminised roughly every 2 years. The word aluminizing suggests that aluminium is involved, which is indeed the case. A very thin layer of very pure aluminium gets deposited onto the mirror's surface in a special vacuum deposition process. This video shows this process in detail from beginning to end. Because aluminizing is a fairly unique process, but since it is needed at every observatory, it is therefore commonly found at observatories. The South African Astronomical Observatory is no exception and has a total of 4 aluminizing tanks of different sizes ranging from 330mm or 13 inches to 2 meters in diameter. In this video, we'll be using the tank capable of handling up to a 40 inch or 1 meter diameter mirror, in which we will be aluminizing a mixture of professional and amateur mirrors, 5 mirrors in total. After preparing the aluminizing lab, the mirrors are unpacked from their shipping containers. A suitable metal ring is then selected for each mirror in order to clamp them vertically in the tank. The mirrors are first rinsed with tap water to get rid of most of the dirt. Then their old reflective surfaces need to be stripped. Mirrors that were previously coated with aluminium only are easily stripped within a few hours using a mild solution of potassium hydroxide. However, mirrors with protected overcoats or very old mirrors that were still silvered can be very stubborn and need something more aggressive. In these cases, ferric chloride works well, as will be seen. Ferric chloride is brown in color and it attacks all metals. Since the large mirror had an aluminium ring attached to it, it was soaked face down in potassium hydroxide overnight. However, the coating would not budge, but at least the metal ring came undone, so it could be stripped using ferric chloride, as can be seen in this time lapse. It took about 3 hours to completely clear. Okay, let's check the oil level. That is fine, and let's start the mechanical pump. Warm it up, so. It needs a bit of assistance, but there it's going. It's about 60 years old, still running fine. Since the stripping process started, the mirrors were not allowed to dry out. They are now given a thorough rinse of 20 minutes to wash off all traces of caustic or ferric chloride. An old garden sprinkler works very well for this. Next, they are washed with a weak solution of sodium lauryl sulfate and given a light rubbing with pure cotton wool. This is followed by another 20 minute rinse with tap water. For the final rinse, deionized water is used liberally. . 100% pure cotton wool is again used for drying. We release the vacuum on the tank before we can open up.
now you start opening the roughing pot. And you'll see that some start kicking into action. As we evacuate the air on the top. Takes about 20 minutes to open the valve fully. Now here's an amazing thing. You saw how I tightened these with these massive spanners before. So the valve isn't fully open yet and I can already hand move that bolt because the air pressure is pushing so hard on sealing the tank further. See the two pumps, the roughing pump is at the back there. This is the line evacuated to the tank. And then the diff pump will come in later to get the good action. Right, 40 minutes later and let's see what the pressure is. Why? 10 to the minus 1. That's actually where we can start this pumping. Now we close the roughing valve. And open this valve. The gear is slight change as we are now evacuating the diff pump itself. But there is still a valve in here that prevents it from working this way. Okay, so now we have evacuated the diff pump enough and we can open the butterfly valve. So now we are roughing through the diff pump, but we haven't started the diff pump yet. That's the next step. So what we do now is we open water flow. So we run water through all these cooling pipes. There's a heater down below that heats some oil. The oil boils, the vapors of the oil reaches the speed of sound in a very funny funnel system, and that gets directed down onto the side of this pump, which is now water cooled, so they recondense and taking molecules with it. This is the way that the pump works. Alright, this is 15 minutes later and now you can see that this pump really kicking and moving to 10 to the minus 2. So if we use the other gauge, the other range, you should see the vacuum drop quite dramatically now. Actually see it moving. You can now also switch on this gauge. And it should start to register soon. As the vacuum reaches 10 to the minus 2, it should start to come up on this gauge. Okay, it's about 2 hours later and the vacuum has moved from there to there, one decade. Tomorrow morning I'm hopefully having it up there somewhere. Okay, another 4 hours later about, and you can see we're heading up to below 2 × 10⁻⁵. Right, overnight, next morning now. And you can see way down, exactly where we want it. So we can go over to Aluminize.
The 12 tungsten coils inside the tank are fired two at a time by changing connections at the back of the tank. Their glow can be seen in the small porthole at the back. Notice a double pulse each time the aluminium melts and cools down the coil slightly. It looks even better with the lights dimmed. GoPro footage looking through the porthole with inset close-up video taken with a cell phone. Not an easy thing to video. See how when the aluminium hooks melt, they cool down the coil slightly. Tiny aluminium balls then form on the coil, which gradually evaporates. This is a view into the side porthole. The mirrors can be seen on the left.
All valves closed, lift pump is off, and we can open up. Now you can release the vacuum on the tank. Slowly open this valve, let the air back in. Also make sure all our bolts are loose. Now for the big reveal. Not bad. Looks pretty good. So the tank has two porthole windows which we look through. So these will of course also aluminize. So these can be replaced, so it's removable. I can take out the glass and take off the aluminium. To see how effective ferric chloride is on freshly aluminized mirrors,
We're then doing this in real time. And I literally wipe away the aluminium. It is that quick. Just try and put a drop there. Should literally eat a hole through there. You can also see how directional aluminizing is. See, this is where the bolts were, and it literally makes a shadow. You can see there.
We need about 60 of these little hooks, pure aluminium. There's this lifty little machine. There's our wire. That is 99.998% pure aluminium. Go.
Need them to be clean because any dirt will come off onto the mirrors, so we will just give them a bit of an alcohol bath.
So the inside of the tank is fitted with 12 of these pure tungsten coils, so now the next trick is to put 5 of these onto each of the coils.